Hey everybody, David here with a video for Mike at Jam On Vinyl, and this is for his Jam On History Contest. Don't drink the water. Mike has hit 270 subs, he's got more than that now, but he wanted to host a contest in which he is calling Jam On History. He wants us to share a playlist of five songs that have some sort of historical significance. It can be five songs about a particular era in history. It can be five individual songs about individual events in history, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to kick things off with Pink Floyd. This is their album, The Division Bell, and the song that I'm going to talk about is A Great Day for Freedom. The song was written by David Gilmour, and it's about the fall of the Berlin Wall. And when it first came down, you know, everyone had high hopes. The lyrics talk about on the day the wall came down, they threw the locks onto the ground, and with glasses high, we raised the cry for freedom had arrived on the day the wall came down. So when the wall came down, you know, people were seeing family members and friends they hadn't seen for so long. The bars were filled and people were just celebrating. But in the second verse, it goes on to talk about now life devalues day by day as friends and neighbors turn away, and as the change that even with regret cannot be undone. And Gilmour says that this is about the ethnic cleansing and genocide that took place in Yugoslavia shortly after the fall of the Berlin Wall. So, A Great Day for Freedom from Pink Floyd off The Division Bell. Next is The Grateful Dead, and the song I'm going to be talking about is Casey Jones. Jonathan Luther Jones was a Kentuckian like me, and he was an engineer who went by the nickname Casey because he was born in Casey, Kentucky, which is in Fulton County. But he was an engineer at the turn of the 20th century, and he was killed in a train collision that happened on April 30th, 1900. He was filling in for an engineer that had called in, and you know, he was trying to make time and make up for lost time, and was you know, driving the rails rather quickly. It was a dark and foggy night, and as he was nearing the station that he was trying to get to, there was a stalled train still on the main rails, and he didn't have time to react to it, and so his train collided with the stalled train, and he was killed on April 30th. He's kind of regarded as a hero because as the train was approaching the stalled train, he never bailed. He could have easily jumped out, but he just stayed at his post and just pulled the horn to give warning to those up ahead that there was, you know, impending danger. And there's still time for them to hopefully get out of harm's way. So, Casey Jones from The Grateful Dead. Next is George Harrison. And this is his album, Somewhere in England. And he has a song that he wrote on this album for his buddy John Lennon, who was killed in December of 1980. And the song is All Those Years Ago. And the lyrics talk about that you were the truth, when you say all you need is love, which is in reference to the infamous Beatles song that, John sang. The lyrics then go on to talk about living with good and bad. I always looked up to you. Now we're left cold and sad by someone, the devil's best friend, someone who offended all, which is referring to Chapman, that who killed John in December of 1980. The lyrics go on to say, and you were the one they backed up to the wall all those years ago. And that's in reference to the Beatles are bigger than God statement that John made. The last part of the song goes on to say, you know, they've forgotten all about God. He's the only reason we exist. Yet you were the one they said was so weird all those years ago. John was quoted as saying, you know, that he's not embarrassed to be a freak and he will never conform to be what someone wants him to be. And that's kind of what that lyric's referring to. The lyrics also say, you know, you were the one who imagined it all, which is in reference to John's song, Imagine. Oh, some more facts about this one, sorry. This was the first time that the surviving Beatles, all three appeared on a track. Ringo, of course, played drums. George wrote the song and performed it, main vocals and guitar work. But Paul also sang backing vocals with Linda McCartney. So this was the first time they appeared after the breakup of the Beatles on track, and they wouldn't do it again until the anthology series, when they recorded three songs that were written by John. Only two were released, which were Free as a Bird and Real Love. So George Harrison, Somewhere in England, all those years ago. Next is the Rolling Stones, and this is their album Beggar's Banquet. And the song I want to talk about is Sympathy for the Devil. Now the song itself has, you know, lots of historical references in the lyrics. It talks about, I killed the king and his minister, Anastasia, screamed in vain, which is in reference to the Romanov family that was killed in Russia. It talks about, I held her rank, drove a general's tank in the Blitzkrieg raid while the bodies stank, which refers to World War I. It talks about the Kennedys' assassinations of John F. Kennedy and Robert F. Kennedy. So the song has lots of historical references, but the song itself is also historical in nature. In December of 1969, there was a free concert that was held at the Altamont Speedway. And this was supposed to be the West Coast's answers to Woodstock, peace and love and all that, but it was anything but that. This is the concert where the Hell's Angels were providing security, and they were paid in beer. So when the Stones took the stage that night, there were, you know, the Hell's Angels had been drinking all day. The crowds had, you know, there had been a lot of fights and stuff that had broken out throughout the day. And Mick says that, you know, when they took the stage, there were like 3,000 or 4,000 people that were crammed up against the stage, and some were trying to climb on to the stage. But when they started to sing Sympathy for the Devil, there was a huge fight that had broken out between some members of the audience and the Hell's Angels. I think when it was all said and done, there were four deaths that were reported that day. Two people were killed by hit and run accidents. There was a person who was stoned on LSD that had drowned in a canal or a puddle. And then there was a man that was stabbed to death at the concert. So the Altamont Speedway free concert was anything but another Woodstock. And the Stones were there, and they were performing Sympathy for the Devil. The last one I want to talk about is one that I don't have on vinyl. I do have it on CD, but it's Dave Matthews Band, and the song is Don't Drink the Water from their album Before These Crowded Streets. It's essentially a song about the Europeans discovering America and basically just taking over and just holding no regard whatsoever for the Native Americans. I'm trying to think some of the lyrics. No room for you, just room for me. Here's the hitch, your horse is leaving. A powerful song about just the complete disregard for the Native Americans and how they were pretty much wiped out because of the Europeans and their greed. So, Don't Drink the Water from Dave Matthews Band. All right, the last part of the challenge was to share your favorite mono album. And this is for a bonus entry into the contest. I'm going to go with the Beatles, and this is in mono. I'm a big Beatles fan. Most of what I have has been remastered and reissued in stereo. This is one that I still have, which is in mono. So there you go, Mike. My brief history lesson and my favorite mono record. Congrats to you and all your subscribers. Your contest was for hitting the 270 mark, but you are well past that now. Mike, for those of you who don't know, is a history teacher. My wife is also a teacher. She teaches high school English. So kudos to you, Mike, for taking on that profession. I hear from my wife every day the horror stories and the highlights of her job. So it's a mixed bag sometimes, but very well respectable job for anyone to have. If you're not familiar with Mike, I'll post a link down below. Go check him out. He has a great page. He's a drummer, a history teacher, as I just mentioned. He has some great taste in music. He's a big Bruce Springsteen fan. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. Until next time, you all, take care and thanks.